Hi, my name is Sam Bendix. I work for National Real Estate Advisors. We're a real estate investment manager based in Washington, D.C. We invest in many different types of assets, office, apartments, but we have a very large investment in data centers in the United States. One of the most common questions I get from investors and managers about data centers is about technological obsolescence. People, of course, buy their iPhones and Androids, and then the next day they become obsolete. So of course they think an asset like data centers that is very reliant on technology would suffer from technological obsolescence. But if you back up and you kind of look at data centers and really what the landlord is responsible for versus the tenant, the landlord is responsible for the heating, the ventilation, the power, which is extremely important, connectivity, the shell itself, and security. The tenant really, at the end of the day, is responsible for the server infrastructure. That's really what people are thinking about when they think about technological obsolescence. So when something becomes obsolete, it's up to the tenant to replace that infrastructure. And of course, that does change over time, but the tenant isn't caught unaware of it. They're researching it, making sure that they have the latest and greatest technology, and they're very reliant on the landlord for things like power, which will continue to become even more critical as technology becomes more advanced and relies more and more on reliable power. The other question that we tend to get is, what's driving data centers today? What are the current demand drivers and what are the future demand drivers? One interesting fact that people usually aren't aware of is that about 60% of the internet traffic in 2018 came from applications like YouTube and Netflix, streaming video. Another 8% came from gaming, which we expect to increase, and then of course, cloud computing, so Microsoft 365, Dropbox, and other applications, things like AWS, they all have the cloud, and that is something that is continuing to grow in the United States. Additionally, we're thinking about what's to come, the future demand drivers in the space, and that's really exciting. There's things like artificial intelligence, which you get a little bit of a sneak preview with Siri and Alexa. We think that that will continue. More and more of our daily lives, our business lives, and everything that we do will become more permeated with artificial intelligence. IoT, or the Internet of Things, will become more pervasive as technology becomes embedded in the devices that we use in our daily lives and also in the economy. And then finally, things like driverless cars that are, I think, on the bleeding edge of technology are something that's really exciting. One estimate by a recent Forbes article assumed that a driverless car would use a petabyte of information. That's kind of hard to understand what that would mean in a year, but that petabyte really comes from the camera and the sensors in the car generating data. That to put that into a little bit more context, there's about 260 million registered vehicles in the United States. And most of those, or many of those, are cars, or passenger vehicles. If you took about 2 million driverless cars, it would generate about as much data as the internet generates today. So it's a pretty incredible demand driver. So we're really excited about the not only things that are driving the use of data centers today, but also in the future. So hopefully that was helpful as far as understanding some of the concerns that people have about data centers, as well as what's driving demand today and tomorrow. Thank you.